To load a 1911, the magazine release is pressed, allowing the magazine to drop out of the pistol. Rounds are loaded and held under the force of the magazine spring. It's then inserted into the magwell and secured by the magazine catch. To chamber the first round, the slide is pulled to the rear, cocking the hammer and compressing the recoil spring. As the slide is released, the bottom edge of the breech face strips the top cartridge and feeds it into the chamber. After the cartridge is chambered, the slide pushes the barrel forward. The barrel pivots forward and up on the barrel link. The locking lugs on the barrel enter the recesses in the slide, locking the barrel to the slide. With the hammer cocked and the barrel locked, the 1911 is ready to fire. The grip safety prevents rearward movement of the trigger. When firmly grasped, the trigger can be pulled. The trigger bar presses against the disconnector, transferring movement to the sear. The sear rotates and disengages the full cock notch on the hammer. The mainspring pushes up on the hammer strut, rotating the hammer forward to strike the firing pin. The firing pin travels forward, impacting the cartridge primer. The expanding gases from the powder charge propel the bullet through the barrel. The recoil forces the slide back and the barrel to unlock. The extractor grips the rim of the spent cartridge case, extracting it from the chamber. As the slide continues to the rear, the casing makes contact with the ejector, forcing it through the ejection port. As the slide comes back, the hammer is cocked and the hammer strut again compresses the main spring. The sear spring presses against the sear, which bears against the hammer. The sear first passes the half-cock notch, which acts as a failsafe in the unlikely event of the full-cock notch failing. It then engages the full-cock notch, holding it in the cocked position. The disconnector prevents the sear from releasing the hammer while the trigger is squeezed. The sear spring pushes the disconnector into its upward position when releasing the trigger. This allows the 1911 to be fired once again. When the hammer is cocked, the thumb safety can be engaged, preventing rearward movement of the slide. On the inside portion of the thumb safety is a stud. The stud prevents sear and hammer movement if the trigger is pulled. Once the final round of ammunition has been fired, the magazine follower pushes up on the slide stop, locking the slide open.